The city of Albuquerque and UNM spent millions of dollars to buy some prime downtown property with a promise of creating an innovation district. Now, about 5 years into the project, some are still wondering if it's still happening. News 13's Chris McKee is live at the Innovate ABQ site near Broadway in Central.
Jessica, officials cut the ribbon on this big Lobo Rainforest building just about 2 years ago, and it is a cornerstone of the Innovate ABQ project. But really, since then, there hasn't been any big construction on this site. So we asked, what's next, or is this it?
We sometimes forget where we started.
It wasn't long ago that almost nothing but vandalism was happening here.
This was a blighted piece of property, right? This was partially a homeless encampment.
The site of the abandoned Baptist Church at Central and Broadway, now the epicenter of the growing Innovate ABQ project led by John Freisinger.
We've managed to re-energize this space, and it's actually a destination now for people.
And so far, they've built the $35 million Lobo Rainforest building, where 250 students live and several national labs have public offices. CNM's Fusemaker space is also open, where people can rent out and use high-tech tools for cheap.
There is something going on here almost every day of the week.
Fully realized, Innovate ABQ is supposed to be a 7-acre campus full of new and remodeled buildings, where science and tech entrepreneurs share working space. But it's been about 2 years since any major construction has even happened on the site.
This is a vibrant community down here.
Freisinger insists the project is still alive and planning its next step.
There's a big demand here in Albuquerque for leasable time within bioscience spaces. And these are like your high school chemistry labs.
Those chem labs are being planned to go in one or two of the old brick church buildings. But crews first have to take out lead paint, asbestos tiles, and clean up pigeon droppings throughout the buildings.
There's a couple of things that we just simply have to get sign-offs on to get the remediation working.
He emphasizes that just because there's no construction now doesn't mean that Innovate is dead.
We don't just build for the sake of building. We have to make sure there's a purpose.
Now, Freisinger says that he is hoping this Innovate project can start remediation work in the old church buildings by late summer. They're also hoping to get a few federal funds to help pay for the cost of that. Jessica?
All right. Thank you, Chris. We also checked on the vacancy rates for the student housing at the Lobo Rainforest. UNM says it's at about 81% occupancy. The money students pay to live there covers the cost of the multi-million dollar yearly lease that UNM pays on the building.